Hello, and welcome back to another episode of 1/35th Scale Figures in Review. It's been a while, and I'm glad I finally believe I got my video issues straightened out so I can bring more things about 1/35th Scale Figures and all the things that go with them to you folks out there in YouTube land. And I'd like to thank all my followers who have kind of stuck with me a little bit. Okay, hopefully I'll be able to produce these about once every week or every 2 weeks so that we kind of keep abreast on what's going on in our little realm of 1/35th scale figures. Now with that, I'm also introducing what I'm calling a builder's blog over a 1/35th scale diorama of Berlin. And it'll feature a Tamiya SU-76, Stalingrad figures that I've already completed, and of course a Verlinden resin set, which is what I'm going to be looking at today. Okay, Verlinden has been around forever, and I also understand that a company is going to pick up the production of these wonderful diorama sets that they had, both in resin and in plaster. Okay, because once again, Verlinden set the standard years ago with dioramas and diorama accessories, let alone how we put them together. Okay, so without further ado, let's get that ball rolling with this real quick review over the street corner diorama in resin from VLS Productions. Okay, now this is the out of the box preview, and I will tell you, because of the issues I had with my previous video over this review of this street corner diorama by VLS. Okay, I already went ahead and did some cleanup. All right, so obviously you're going to see a little bit more of a clean pieces and parts here, but it's still worth seeing what you get out of the box. Okay, so this is a typical VLS box. Okay, no issues, plain Jane, great reference image on the front, which is outstanding to have. Okay, and then when you open it up, you're going to get basically just three pieces are going to come inside the box. Okay, it's packed very well when you're bubble wrapped. Okay, and then we'll go ahead and show you the one piece right here. Okay, which is the front of the street corner. All right, we'll go ahead and put that right over here. Okay, you're going to see the second, okay, which is the sidewall to the diorama coming down the street, which makes obviously the street corner. All right, and then last but by far not least is the base. Okay, the base is a wonderfully rendered piece of resin. All right, let me take it all the way out of the box for you. Put her down just like so, and that's what you get out of the box. Okay, and I'll show you the close-ups here in a little bit about what this all looks like. Okay, so here you have your cobblestones. Okay, you have a shell hole set up right here. Here you have some beautifully molded debris. Okay, now this is going to be sitting in a Berlin setting for my builder's blog, but when I do this, I'm going to actually from period photos add a lot more debris. But this is beautifully taken care of as it is right here. You have a empty ammo box right here. You have a food container right here. Here's another box. Okay, here's drop pieces from the building. Okay, and as you kind of turn this around a little bit, you see the backside, all right, which once again has really nice pieces of rubble set into it. Okay, you even have a porcelain basin for your bathroom right in here. Okay, all right, now just to kind of show you how this kind of comes together, all right, and I did not, when I took this back apart, I use blue tack to hold the pieces in, and the other video I'll show you will have this. So here's your one street corner. We'll sit in here like this. That's the front of the building. All right. Okay. And then if you can, you go ahead and you'll put in the second part of the building back on the back side right here. Okay. So that's what the pieces look like when you get them all together. Okay. Now, just so you know, and I'll show you the backside in a close-up here in a minute, okay? But obviously, you're going to have to do, I did some massive amount of cleanup of resin flash in the windows, getting on the sides and things like this. Here's a gap that's right here coming down in the building itself, all right? But overall, those are not things we can, that'll hold us back very much if you're going to go ahead and put your diorama together. But now I will show you okay, the backside of these buildings, because there's no texturing, okay, on the backside. Okay, it's just flat resin, right? And there's even a couple of holes you see right here of air bubbles from the inside. Okay, now, usually in some of the Verlinden diodes, you only can see it from three sides, so the backside usually is not very much detailed. But in this case, since they have so much rubble on the inside, you're going to want to have your diode be able to be viewed from 360 degrees. Okay, a full circle video or full circle image. Okay, and then once again, here's the backside of this. Once again, there was a lot of cleanup was taken care of right here, a lot of resin flash. But obviously, once again, as an average Joe modeler, if I can do that, okay, anybody can. My challenge is going to be the texturing and how to make the interior look to match up to the other pieces that you have on the backside of the resin. Okay, here's an image or a video of the completed diorama set put together with the walls and the base put down. Now, I will tell you, there was a lot of cleanup involved in the two side buildings or side walls that you see right here. Okay, and I'll show you here in a minute as we go through the turn. Okay, the rubble out in front is absolutely outstanding. Okay, it's beautifully molded. There's a lot of little pieces here and there that are actually really nice. Okay, here's an empty ammo crate, things like this. Here's a shell hole created in the cobblestone street. The cobblestones were very well defined. Okay, but once again, the kind of a drawback to this is you had a lot of thick resin buildup in the windows. Okay, you had a lot of cleanup around here. And as I do my slow turn, okay, of the completed diorama base as it's put together, you see a seam you're going to have to work on filling in. And on the base, okay, right here, you have a big gap that you're going to have it filled in, but that'll be taken care of with any rubble. But as I turn here, once again, is kind of the drawback to our put together resin diorama base. There's no interior texturing. All right, and you even have the big pothole right here. So a friend of mine, Roger Sam, suggested that I go ahead and add a coat of texturing, even with plaster, a Paris or putty, put on the inside to give a little bit of texture. And here's wonderful rubble that's on the inside, which once again is very well rendered. You even have a bathroom basin sitting right here. Okay, now some of this will obviously be covered up, because if you make an interior here, you're gonna have to have some other things covering this up. So I'm gonna have to build up the window sills, the doors and things like that, but that's all part of building the diorama. So all in all, after you get past the cleanup of this, okay, it winds up being pretty good. All right, and I'll go ahead and come back around after I do my turn here with you folks. Okay, and I'm gonna show you and what I'll kind of have in scale. Now I don't have the SU-76 built up, but this is what it's going to look like with a comparable sized vehicle coming around the corner. This is my Tamiya M3 Stewart, which is an absolutely beautiful little kit in its own right. Okay, but that's kind of the how things are going to look when this kit is done. Okay, I'll go ahead and have some stills for you here in a minute of some close-ups of the different pieces and different close-ups of the rubble and things like this. But it's all in all, this is going to be a pretty good build-up. It's just going to take a little bit of work to get through some of the things we have to. So glad to be back, and hopefully I'll keep adding little video pieces to this. I have some mini art accessories I'm going to add to this, and that'll probably be my next little video review. So until next time, from 1/35th scale figures in review, if you like what you see, subscribe, and thanks for taking a peek.